What the hell do you want?
I just found out about the garage sale down at Blue Star.
Why?
Last night I was reading Rudy the story of Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Pot. You know what happened? Stuck his nose in the pot once too often, and he got stuck.
Maybe you ought to read him Pinocchio, Gordon. I thought that you were going to turn Blue Star around, not upside down. You fucking used me.
Well, you're walking around blind without a cane, pal. Fool and his money are lucky enough to get together in the first place.
But why do you need to wreck this company?
Because it's wreckable, all right? I took another look at it and I changed my mind.
If these people lose their jobs, they got nowhere to go. My father has worked there for 24 years. I gave him my word.
It's all about bucks, kid. The rest is conversation. Hey, buddy, you're still going to be president, all right? And when the time comes, you're going to parachute out a rich man. With the money you're going to make, your dad's never going to have to work another day in his life.
So tell me, Gordon, when does it all end, huh? How many yachts can you water ski behind? How much is enough?
It's not a question of enough, pal. It's a zero-sum game. Somebody wins, somebody loses. Money itself isn't lost or made. It's simply transferred from one perception to another. Like magic. This painting here, I bought it 10 years ago for $60,000. I could sell it today for $600,000. The illusion has become real. And the more real it becomes, the more desperate they want it. Capitalism at its finest.
How much is enough, Gordon?
The richest 1% of this country owns half our country's wealth, $5 trillion. One-third of that comes from hard work. Two-thirds comes from an inheritance, interest on interest accumulating to widows and idiot sons. And what I do, stock and real estate speculation.